Hey guys, welcome back to Top 10 Comics to Buy to Improve Your Comic Book Collection. This is another special edition, Uncanny X-Men. 10 of the best between number 200 and 300. This is also great spec, guys. Great speculation here. Try to pick these up. These are very reasonable right now. So let's get right to it.
Are you ready for the sickness? Let's get into it.
Now, before we get started, a couple things. Number one, we're going to do all near mint. There's no 9.2s. 9.2 is near mint minus. These are all raw. Near mint is a 9.4. Near mint plus is a 9.6. Near mint to mint is a 9.8. So raw copies, guys. Now, also, all these books are signed. So get that out of your mind. I just have them all signed. So just imagine the signatures weren't there. We'll talk about it just a little bit. But besides that, these are my top 10 between 200 and 300 for Uncanny X-Men. And they're super reasonable. The research I was finding and kind of completed listings and stuff like that were really low. I was really surprised. So, I mean, they might be asking more. But in regard to completed sales, I'm going to give you an average, okay? So we're going to start with number 222. This is number 10. And it's basically X-Men versus Marauders, but it's definitely a classic Silvestri cover with Sabretooth and Wolverine. Mine just is happened to be signed by Mark Silvestri and Chris Claremont, the writer. But you guys have seen these all the time. These are selling for, in a raw 9.4 condition, unsigned, $10 to $15. I would seriously suggest you guys maybe start to pick up some of these X-Men soon, but sooner than later. But that's number 10 on our list, number 222. So let's move on to number 9. Okay, at number 9, we have X-Men number 256. This is the debut of Psylocke's new costume type of thing. Jim Lee, Claremont, stuff like that. In a near mint condition, you're also looking at about $10 to $15, which, I mean, I gotta be honest, I find really amazing. There's a first appearance in here too as well, but the deal here is the Psylocke costume. And of course, in a near mint condition, 9.4 raw. This just happens to be a newsstand and signed by Chris Claremont. But one of my favorites, I'm telling you guys, these are the top 10 for 200 to 250 to 300. So look for them in your stores, okay? Let's move on to number 8. At number 8 on my list today, we have number 212. This is the first time Sabretooth and Wolverine battle. I absolutely love this cover. It is super sieknas. There's a lot of Wolverine stuff in these issues, of course, especially the Claremont run. But you're looking probably in a near mint condition, raw, $15 to $20. This one just happens to be signed by Chris Claremont as well. I have all the Chris Claremont stuff signed, so you're going to see him on everything. But classic, classic cover. Let's move on to the next one. At number 7, one of my favorites, number 248. This is the first Jim Lee cover. They sell anywhere from $10 to $15. I'm really amazed at the prices. So that's why I'm saying, guys, you know, start hunting now. It won't last forever. So yeah, in a near mint, $10 to $15. First Jim Lee cover, classic cover. This one happens to be signed by Jim Lee and Chris Claremont. But you guys probably see these in your stores a lot, or maybe on the wall. You know, pull the trigger, guys. Pull the trigger on these, especially if they're a high grade like this. All right, let's get to number 6. Okay, at number 6, we have number 211 in a near mint condition. This is the first full appearance of the Marauders. Everyone always goes after these anniversary. I think it's a FF anniversary cover. Always go after these anniversary covers. But in a near mint condition with the first Marauders, you're looking at probably, I think it's $15 to $20, which is still crazy. Classic Wolverine cover too. And I love it. It has all the different characters on there. This one is signed by Chris Claremont and John Romita Jr. And yeah, these are highly sought after, the frame comics. Love this one. All right, what do we got? Number five. Okay, coming in at number five on my near mint list between 200 and 300, we have number 213. Classic Wolverine Sabretooth cover, one of my favorites. You're looking at about $10 to $15 on this too, which is nuts to me. And it's a cameo appearance of Mr. Sinister. I would say start looking for those Sinister books. This one just happens to be signed by Chris Claremont as well. But I love this cover. I'm blown away at how cheap these are still. Well, I'm sure they're listed for more, but the completed listings were in those areas that I was talking about. So let's get on to your four, last four. All right, coming in at number four, we have, in a near mint condition, Uncanny X-Men number 201. Baby Cable. Yay, little Baby Cable. You guys see this a lot. You know what? A lot of stores, they're there at the store in the back issue, so just look for them. In a near mint, you're looking at probably 15 to 20, I think, on the first Baby Cable. This one is double signed, Chris Claremont and Will Spartaccio, artist. And this is a great book to have. You know, Cable, he's a classic. He's a classy guy. Everyone likes a little Cable. So this would be his first real appearance, I guess, as a baby. All right, let's move on to number Trace. All right, and number three, in a 9.4 raw condition, we have X-Men number 244, first appearance of Jubilee. Okay. In a near mint raw, you're looking anywhere from $30 to $50. But I would be real careful. Make sure you check the book really good, and it's really, really solid. This one just happens to be signed by Claremont, and I believe it's Mark Silvestri. Yeah, the cover artist or internal artist. I think it's cover artist. But yeah, this book I think is starting to heat up too. But at that price, it's well worth looking around for it. Most likely it'll be on a wall, but you might be able to find it in the back issues. So 244, first appearance of Jubilee. So let's go on. We got two more. Two more on my top 10 between number 200 and 300. Let's do this. Okay, guys, at number two on the list, we have X-Men number 221. This is the first full appearance of Mr. Sinister. There's a lot of spec on this book. Regardless, it's a good book to get anyway in a near mint condition. You're looking at $50 to $80 raw. It just depends on how clean it is. This one's also signed by Silvestri and Claremont. But if you're in the store and you're flipping around and you're looking and you see this book in the bin, pull it. Great book to have. What's great about this episode is that every book is in near mint condition. So it's not jumping around grades and different prices. So they're all based on that near mint raw condition scale. And you can decide. I've put my top 10 in the way I wanted to. But it's logical, but gives you the baseline near mint 9.4. So let's move on to number one, and I'm sure you all know what it is. You guessed it, 266. First? Oh, it's not first appearance. Okay, you're right. First cover appearance of Gambit. Okay, now This book is more expensive than the annual 14, which I believe myself too, that the annual is his first full appearance. There's so many panels in that book with him in it. So it's kind of hard to pass that up. But this is his first cover, and this is the more sought after book, period. In a near mint condition, you're looking for $150 and up, raw. Now, this one's signed by a bunch of people, okay? I'll try to point them out just for fun. You know, Jim Lee, Chris Claremont, Joe Rubenstein, Andy Kubert, I think that's it. Yeah, four signatures on that one, but just imagine they're not there, but they are. This is a newsstand, too. Probably command a little bit more, especially with the signatures, too. Some people don't like it. I don't care. That was my thing, getting the collection signed and making sure they're all fire. So this is the top book in Uncanny X-Men between 200 and 300. This is the number one book you want to look for, at least in my mind. 150 and up. First cover, second full appearance or whatever of Gambit. And I really hope you guys enjoyed this special X-Men. I liked doing it because it broke it down to the top 10 within 100 books. And I can do that easily with X-Men. But I'll try to do more specials more often. But we're coming off the Amazing Spider-Man one that I'll add at the end of this video so you can watch it. But we're going to go back to some random things next week. But these books are great speculation books, guys. All of them. So at the prices that they're at now, I seriously suggest trying to get some if you don't already have them. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please subscribe. Please comment. Please throw up a like. Please share. Please do all those wonderful things. And we'll see you next week at Economics and Comics. Have a great day.